हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर वेलकम इन सीक्वेंस एंड सीरीज पार्ट 5. दिस इज चैप्टर 9. वी आर डूइंग क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 9.2. नाउ टुडे 16 क्वेश्चन. बिटवीन 1 and 31 एम नंबर्स हैव बीन इंसर्टेड इन सच ए वे दैट द रिजल्टिंग सीक्वेंस इज एन एपी. रेशियो ऑफ 7th एंड एमएनएस 1th नंबर इज 5:9. फाइंड वैल्यू ऑफ एम. लेट एम नंबर्स आर A1, A2, A3 अप टू AM. Now, if you insert these numbers between 1 and 31, then 1 A1 up to AM, this will be an AP, and whose first term is 1. Number of terms are M plus 2, and let common difference is D. So, AM plus 2, that is equal to 31, so M plus 2th term, and M plus 2th term, that is using formula A plus M plus 1 into D, and it is equal to 31. Put value of A1 and calculate D. It is 30 upon M plus 1. Now we are given in the question that 7th number upon M minus 1th number, M minus 1th number, that is equal to 5.9. So 7th number, that will be 8th term in the sequence. You see, A1, it is second term. A2, it will be third term. So 7th A7 will be 8th term. M minus 1th number will be mth term. So you can put this value like this. So A8 upon AM is equal to 5/9. Using formula A8 can be written as A plus 7D. AM using formula A plus M minus 1 into D. Using general term formula, and you put value of D. It is 30 upon M plus 1, we have already calculated. Now you cross multiply, you take LCM and cross multiply, and we will have the value of M 14. You do the calculations and value of M will be 14. This is answer. I hope it is clear. Now question number 18. The difference between any two consecutive interior angles of a polygon is 5 degrees. If the smallest angle is 120 degrees, find the number of sides of the polygon. Now, the smallest angle is 120 degrees, and all angles that will be greater to it, so that will be in increasing order, you can say, and let the number of sides is equal to n. In a n-sided polygon, the number of angles will also be n. Just like in a quadrilateral, 4 sides, but angles are also 4, so that's why in n-sided, so angles that will be equal to n. Difference of two consecutive angles, that is given 5. Now these angles will form an AP, because the first angle, that is 120, and each angle that is 5 degrees greater, so you see common difference, that will be 5. Number of terms, that is equal to n. Now sum of angles of a polygon, we have a formula for this. This is n minus 2 into pi. In a n-sided polygon, the sum of angles of the all angles of the polygon, that will be n minus 2 into pi. So it means sum of the angles, first angle 120, second angle 5 degrees greater means 125, and so on up to n terms, the sum should be equal to n minus 2 into pi. This is AP having n terms, and apply the formula for sum of n terms, that is Sn, n by 2, 2 into A, that is 120, plus n minus 1 into D, it is 5. So you can simplify this, you will form a quadratic equation. This is quadratic equation, and after dividing it by 5, we have n square minus 25n plus 144, and using splitting middle term method, it is n minus 16 into n minus 9, and value of n is 16 and value of n is 9. So I hope you can verify. So it is both answers are correct. Now I hope this AP that is completed, and you try all questions of 9.2. We can discuss the problems. Now the next exercise is based on geometric progression. Today we will understand what is a GP. If in any sequence A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, let this is a sequence, If ratio of two consecutive terms a2 upon a1, a3 upon a2, a4 upon a3 and so on, if it is same, then that sequence is called geometric. In the AP, difference, in GP, ratio. So ratio of two consecutive terms, that should be same. If you generalize, so it is ak plus 1 upon ak. That should be same throughout by changing the values of k, and the value of k that will be 1 or greater than 1. Now this common ratio, this ratio that is common for all, and it is denoted by R. So this R is called common ratio, and that can be calculated a2 upon a1, a3 upon a2. So it means if you want to verify this is sequence as a GP, geometric progression, so the common ratio a2 upon a1, a3 upon a2, a4 upon a3, a5 upon a4, all you have to calculate, and if it is same, then it will be GP. So that ratio is called common ratio, and we will denote it by R. Now let first term is A, common ratio is R, so second term that will be AR, so this is called general GP, AAR, AR square, AR cube and so on. So you can check that second term upon first term is equal to third term upon second term, that is same throughout. So this is a GP, and general term of GP, that is A into R raised to the power n minus 1. General term, it is called AN, nth term. So if we want to calculate any terms, we will use this formula. Suppose we want to find 17th term of this sequence. So you put values there, value of n 17, so it will be a into r raised to the power 16. So this is the method to calculate the terms, and that's all for today. Thank you.